Alright guys, welcome back to another True Story Animation reaction video. Today we are watching Sunscreen Doesn't Work on Me by My Story Animated. I'll leave their links down below if you guys want to go check them out. All credits go to them. But I just want to say sunscreen doesn't work on me either. I get sunburned super easily. I think it's because I'm so pale or something like that. I don't know. If you guys have that same problem, let me know down below. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and leave a like on this video. Let's go ahead and get started. Check out another true story animation.
Hi, my name is Selena. Do you know Selena, the feeling of having an annoying sister in your life who is just there to ruin everything for you?
No, because I don't have any sisters.
Mine is a psycho jealous sister. She used my condition against me, but I got rid of her eventually.
She got rid of her sister?
I was born to super, super rich parents.
How'd she do that?
Owned more than half the city. And after I was born,
must be nice.
They just went crazy with happiness.
Must be nice
on
to be rich,
first tooth party,
to be born rich.
My dad organized a water park party for all the kids.
To have,
but when mom brought
not
me
a
outside,
worry in your life.
I started yelling and my skin turned super red, like blood.
Luckily,
there was a doctor in the crowd and he came running to help. I was diagnosed with extreme photosensitivity that would only increase as I aged. Basically, I could never step out in the sun without getting burned.
Dude, she's a vampire, guys. She's a vampire.
Indoors during the day, and all the windows were covered with black curtains.
Dang, she's a zombie. She's a vampire.
I cried and said, "I want to go to school and have friends." Oh, honey, you can't. But we'll bring them
both
to you.
That's so sad.
We'll hire private teachers for you. And
dude, must be nice to be rich, guys. If they weren't rich, they wouldn't have been able to do any of that.
Kind of my best friend.
Aww.
All was good until my little sister was born. Her name was Rita, and she was pure evil. I discovered she was jealous of me once she turned 3. She knew about my condition, but she was still angry that my parents paid more attention to me. She got me a piece of cake with a candle on it.
I got the opposite, guys.
Said,
my parents paid more attention to my brother.
"Now, this candle will burn you." "No, honey. I'm only allergic to the sun, not candles."
Oh, she's like, "Oh, so now I know your weakness."
"Oh, so it won't hurt you? Well then, okay." And with that,
I'll find something that hurts you.
She threw the candle on my bed, and the blanket instantly caught fire. I started yelling for my parents, and I almost got hurt getting out of the room. Once, when I was 8,
that is really messed up.
Rita threw a tantrum that she wanted to be homeschooled like me, but of course, my parents refused. What made
they're like, we should have never had a
second
kid.
My parents invited everyone to a super fancy restaurant at night. One sophisticated lady saw me and said to mom, "Oh, your daughter is very pretty. Like, too pretty. But the other one, oh, she's not pretty."
Who says that? No, who says that to someone's, like, to a stranger's kid? "Oh, your daughter's pretty, but the other one is ugly." Come on, dude.
"Like, too pretty, but the other one
is ugly.
She's not pretty, like, at all."
What?
"Oh, yes, the youngest one is just ugly.
What?
I wonder if she'll ever get married."
Who says that, dude?
And flung juice straight at the women's faces.
I mean, deserved.
Then she turned to me. "You just wait and watch, Selena. I'm gonna make you wish you were the ugliest girl on the planet.
Dude, what the
heck? Praying to God to make you ugly."
What kind of sister is that?
I was asleep when I heard some noises. I opened my eyes to see Rita holding a big poster of her drawings. Things like her hanging someone up, crucifying others, and taking someone's eye out. Do you see this eye?
That's gonna be yours,
babe. But one day, it's gonna be mine. I stood up and pushed
her
away
and
locked
really
the door behind
her.
She was a total psycho.
That's so scary.
Over the coming years,
I would live in fear.
Rita just wouldn't understand that I got special treatment because of my condition. I tried to reason with her, so I thought maybe throwing a party where we could both invite our friends would help us get closer.
Gosh.
What a stupid decision that was. I was 13 back then and invited the only two friends I had, Mark and Emily, while Rita invited half the school. Suddenly, during the party, Rita stood in front of everyone holding up a drawing I'd made. It was the three of us, me, Mark, and Emily. "Listen here, everyone. So our princess Selena can draw, but she also has a little secret. Let me read it for you. I'm so in love with Mark, but I also love Emily. I will soon ask them both out and kiss them both at the same time. I will kidnap Emily if she rejects me. We will be the happiest
lovers triangle." So she's making up stuff now?
Everyone went silent.
That's really
messed
up.
And Mark and Emily turned red. I couldn't believe my sister would lie like that. No, you liar. I didn't write that. You just came up with it. Why are you so evil? Why are you so perfect? I'm not, Rita. I wish I was normal, just like you. Oh, like me? You wish. I would never have a boyfriend and a girlfriend at the same time. That's just shameless. Ew. You do that to the only two people
who like
you?
That is so evil.
That's just dumb and gross. Just stop it. Just then, Mike took Emily's hand and left.
What?
I was so shocked and embarrassed that I didn't...
I thought his name was Mark, not Mike.
...even stop them. I just went to my room and locked the door, and the party continued like nothing had happened. After that day, I knew I had to teach Rita a lesson, and I knew
that
the best way to tease her was to live my life to the fullest. The very next day, I invited
Mark
over. When he came to my room, I made sure to leave the door open so Rita could hear everything. Mark, I'm really sorry about last night. You know that my sister is... Listen, Selena, I don't believe a word your psycho sister says, but I was just too embarrassed to say, so I left. I put my finger on his mouth and pulled him closer to kiss
him. Yo!
Will you be...
Yo!
Be my boyfriend, Mark? He said yes, and we hugged.
Dang.
Then I heard Rita's room door
close nice to be pretty.
Very hard. In your face, witch. Over the next 2 years, Rita was always making it obvious how jealous she was of me for having a boyfriend. She even tried to break into
my room
several
times. That's what she gets for doing all that.
Once, she used a knife to open it, but luckily I was ready. I attacked her with pepper spray and ran to my parents.
Dude, what is happening?
She was 4 years older than her.
Dang, he is giant.
Dad totally lost it and kicked
him
out.
Get out of here.
My parents were getting so tired of her craziness. But the last straw was when she called the police at midnight once. To my horror, she slipped her t-shirt off her shoulder to show scratches on her skin.
To lie that she attacked her?
And she pointed accusingly at Mark.
What?
He's dangerous. He attacked me. I barely managed to escape. What? My parents told the cops that she was making it all up, and Mark would never do such a thing.
I'm glad her parents have her back.
If you're so jealous, just get yourself a boyfriend, you ugly psycho bimbo. I expected her to say something harsh,
that is rough.
But instead she started crying and fell on her knees.
Yo, she
looks
weak for the first time.
See,
she gave up.
See how my family treats me? Just take me away from them. Please, help me. Please, save me. What an actress.
And now she's playing the victim card, huh?
My parents took Rita to a psychologist. Turned out my sister had some issues and needed therapy every few days. But she didn't take that so well.
Uh-oh.
After a few days,
I got back
from my date with Mark, I found Rita had prepared
meat sandwiches
for me.
Nah,
what
don't
did
eat
she
that.
Want? To poison me? I said no and went to my room.
For
I
sure
to
they're
my
poisoned.
My little hamster, but I didn't find him there. I started looking everywhere.
She made the sandwiches out of the hamsters? No way.
And it hit me. Oh my god.
Oh
I ran
god,
back to her.
Dude.
Where is my hamster? I don't know. What did you
There's
do
no
to
way.
My hamster?
That is murder.
Mom, Dad, Rita ate my hamster. And then I passed out. When I woke up, my parents told me that they had talked to Rita's doctor and she might be admitted to a psychiatric ward. I wasn't really happy
She's
to hear
crazy.
That, but I knew it was for everyone's
like,
safety.
Actually.
A month later, Rita was gone and
Dang, she got
to
taken
hospital.
Away to the
Life was good and I had the
psycho
best time
ward,
with
the
Mark
psych
and Emily.
Ward.
4 years passed, and it was the day of my graduation.
Wow.
I was so in love with Mark that I wanted to marry him right away,
dang.
Even though we were so
That's
young.
So cute.
He agreed, and
That's
my parents
so
suggested he move in with us. So he did.
Dang.
During the day, Mark would leave for college, and I would stay home. One day, I called for the maids to get me something to eat, but no one responded. I went downstairs
Uh-oh.
And found no one. Then I heard a familiar voice. I
She's
was
back.
Sure it was the voice of my hamster. But it seemed to be coming from the backyard. I thought
Wait,
I'd
what?
Just take a quick look and it wouldn't hurt me. But I just popped my
what
head
happened
out
to
the
her
door
hamsters?
When suddenly someone pulled me out.
Oh, shoot!
Course.
She's
hey,
back, isn't she?
Miss me, sis? What are you doing here? Oh, well, they decided to let me go. I
oh,
feel much better,
dang.
Actually. You really thought your
She's
hamster
here for
came
revenge.
Back to life? Are you still that dumb?
So she did kill her
girl.
Hamsters.
And then she pulled me out more, and I was under direct sunlight.
Oh, shoot! I just remembered she can't go into the sun.
It started to hurt my skin, and I screamed.
Oh, God.
One of the maids heard us and came running. When Rita saw her, she let me go and ran away. Thankfully, I wasn't hurt,
Sheesh, that is really messed up.
Rita had run away from the asylum, and they were looking for her now. I was sad for how things had turned out in my family.
She has a crazy sister.
But my sadness was short-lived because I soon found out that I was pregnant.
What? Isn't she 18 or something?
To my beautiful daughter.
I could have sworn she just graduated high school.
When Sally started to crawl, we all knew she was a really curious, naughty baby. Once she crawled out the
kitchen. Hey! That is Squid Game.
All knew she was a really curious, naughty
Squid Game
baby. Once she
everything
crawled
I see just reminds me of Squid Game now, guys.
And she was completely quiet. I got scared and ran after her with the meat.
Her baby has the same.
When I got there, I saw another basket next to her.
Wait, what?
And a freaking baby in it. It was a boy. The note next to him said, "This is John, your nephew. I gave birth to him months ago and wanted to raise him, but I discovered that was hard. So I sent him to you, Selena. Take care of him, I guess."
Wait, what?
I looked at the baby's face and tears rolled down my cheeks. I kissed his forehead.
Wait, how is she in the sun all of a sudden?
Full of surprises. When I was about to shut the door and run to my parents, someone pushed it against me.
Oh my gosh, she's back again, wasn't she?
Oh, you're crying. And she pulled me into the backyard
again. Oh, again?
Thankfully, the maids were able to catch her and call the police. Rita was sent to jail this time. And I
she really tried
order.
Doing that again.
Me and my family were finally safe.
Oh my gosh.
And baby John? Yeah, he was hers, and he lived with us.
Aww.
I raised him like mine.
That's so
and
cute.
And now I have four kids, and we are
four
a happy
kids?
Family.
Dang. Happily ever after. I'm just glad that was there was a happy ending to this story. I mean, it sucks that she had that condition, but hey, at least she was able to live a happy life because of her parents, you know, being able to provide everything for her, private schooling, got her friends and stuff. That's awesome, guys. That's awesome. But anyways, if you guys enjoy this video, make sure you guys leave a like and subscribe because we are super, super close to 1 million subscribers. I don't know, guys, maybe by the time this video goes up, I might have already hit it. But thanks so much for the support. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace. Yes.